Hyderabad met with a lot of bad incidents in the last couple of months. On last January 17, one of our beloved friend got institutionally murdered. That was the day which we cried a lot. But the tears were not coming through our eyes. It was the fuel to continue a struggle to throw out the murderers, which includes DC Professor Appa Rao from his position. He ran away from the University of Hyderabad and he even went to the abroad. We came back to a situation, an academical normalcy, where we were enjoying the academics which we used to do in Hyderabad campus. We are reaching to a situation in which we are completing our syllabus and we are just nearby to the end semester exams. At this point of time, he came back to the campus by the disrespecting the judicial inquiry which is happening on the Rohit Vemmala's institutional murder. He is a person who disrespected the judicial system. He is a person who destroyed the normalcy of our campus. It was very calculated attempt to destroy our sphere. He given the task list to his subordinates and then to the like-minded faculties that you have to do this, that and those to completely destroy the campus atmosphere. We came to a normalcy after 15 days of continuous protest. When he came back, we saw that how a person can destroy the evidences, how a person can make the confrontation in between the students and in between the students and the faculty and in between the students and the non-teaching staff. We witnessed everything. That was the day on 22nd of the March. We get to know that he resumed the office and he is conducting an executive council meeting in the BC's lodge. We the students went for the protest to that place. There were students from the different departments and even ABP students who were the gates of the BC lodge were open for them and it was closed for us. And there were teaching staff and so many other people as well. And the provocation and the outburst of the feelings happened. And then police informed that they will be removing the BC from that BC lodge. When a police went and speak to the BC, he clearly said that this is my private residence and I am not going to move from this position. And you, the state missionary, should use your power to throw out the students who were protesting outside the bungalow or the BC's lodge. And we witnessed the brutal attack by the police. Our girl students were brutally attacked and they were dragging them out of the compound. And some of the students who got beaten up and they fell down. Some of us tried our level best to take them to the hospital. And we asked the police, what the hell are you doing? You at least allow us to take our students who got beaten up. Then the police officials replied that these are the people reserved for the jail, not for the hospital. And we understood that the government, the Sanghi forces, which believe in the purity of the fire. What is the logic which they always used to give that? Fire will make everything pure. That's the reason why the fire will be present in the yagams and all. But we believe the water will purify each and everything and it will get itself unclean. And you believe the purity in which purity of the food which will lead to the killing of the Aghlaq and two more people who were trying to sell the beef. You believe in the purity of the higher educational institutions in which you will destroy each and everything. You destroy the academic sphere. You will even try your level best to close the campuses where a lot of students from the poor and rural background students are studying. They were using the higher educational system, higher educational institutions for the academic purposes. You want to close it. You want to open the private institutes because we, the students, we understand very clearly that we are the people who are using the money which given taken from the poor vegetable merchants in the tea sellers and all. But you will stand with always Adanis and Abanis, because for your suits and cars, the money which given by the poor people won't be sufficient enough. You will be required to take the money from those, the richer parts of the people, and a crony capitalist system will arise in our country. That's what we have observed. And now, when the Aparahu coming back to the situation, coming back to the University of Hyderabad, that is a direct destruction into our academic sphere. And we witness that, how we will deny the basic needs of the students. He denied the food, water, internet, and even power to some of the hostels. And that person, when he was sitting in the position of the VC, the appellate authority of the University of Hyderabad, we cannot expect a proper judicial inquiry to happen. He will try his level best to give the offers to the staff to give their dialogue in favor of him. We are very clear on that side. So we are presenting our demands very firmly that the students, 24 students and one journalist and two of our faculties got arrested on that day. This includes Students Union Vice President Venkatesh Chauhan. We demand immediate release of the students and the faculties got arrested on that day. And we also demand arrest and the sacking of VC Aparao from his position. We also demand demilitarization of the campus. This was the campus where we get a lot of freedom to roam around. Now our movement will be restricted by the police. We don't want such kind of the freedom, such kind of a university to roam around. And also we demand to avoid the targeted attack on the students. At the present, 51 students got booked by the several cases. And the university filed a case against 9 students particularly. And we are getting to know that university is constituting a committee to enquire into that matter. This is nothing but the student leaders who always chant and who always interfere into the student-related issues should be thrown out from the campus. And he want to do a detector's law rule inside our campus. We are not going to allow that. We want to continue our struggles. We want to give the safety and the security for the democratic sphere which is existing inside our campus. And for that purpose, we are appealing to you all. We understand that his idea is to destruct our academic sphere. He is a person who given 4 days of continuous holidays. He is a person who tried his level best to approach the faculties. And still, at the present, we got a message that he asked the faculties to compulsorily be present in corresponding departments at morning 8:45. And I don't know what he is meaning to by that. But our side is very clear. We want to continue our academics, but a question still stands in front of us. When our 24 of our students and 2 faculties were staying inside the jail, are we that much inhuman to go to the classes? And we clearly announced that we are not that inhuman. We are not Aparaus. We are not Sankey forces. We are not the right-wing forces. We will stay away from the classes for tomorrow. And Joint Action Committee for the Social Justice appeal to the student community to voluntarily boycott the classes and join at the shop home for the protest. And also, tomorrow there is a seminar is going to happen in the physics department. We want to happen that program. It should happen. But we request the physics department that please don't call VC Aparao to inaugural ceremony. He is not the person to do the inaugurals. He is a person reserved to kill the students, to destroy our campus. He should not be invited to the seminar. And that is our humble request to the physics department. And we will be giving the pamphlets. We'll be giving pamphlet in front of the seminar room with the FIP seminar is going to happen. And we will be closing our mouths to show that unannounced emergency which is prevailing inside the campus. We are completely isolated from the outside. The media is not allowed to come inside. Our parents are not allowed to come inside. The lawyers or the human rights activists are not allowed to come inside. But we won't. We can't bear with such kind of the actions. We clearly demand to the administration that you should stop it immediately. Else, the consequences, you are the people who have to suffer the consequences. Don't blame the students at that point of time as well. And we request all of you to gather at Shopcom just after boycotting your classes. Then at the evening, we are expecting the parents of the arrested students will be joining with us. We will be having a public gathering. And also we are expecting that our friends will be getting the bail. Whatever the time they get the bail, we will wait for them to greet them, to give the warm welcome for them. This is not the warm welcome. This is not the welcome which some of the students, especially ABP students, given to the upper row. This is the welcome. These are greetings to the students who protested, who struggled for the cause of the students, for the justice. This was a fight for the justice, and all over India, the consensus are forming in support of us. Several students' organizations and the campuses extended their support for our protest. The sound, the slogans, which is arising from the different campuses, from the ACU, from the JNU, DU, IFLU, MANU, and anywhere and everywhere, will come together. That was a sound which will be going to destroy the Sanghi government and their chair where they are sitting very peacefully by making a lot of problem for the students, for the poor and the Dalits. And here, there, the 56 inch of our Prime Minister won't be sufficient enough to support or restrict the force which we will create. We will be speaking on behalf of the thousands of the people or the lakhs of the people who lost their rights under this government. We will be speaking loudly and loudly without any fear. You cannot make us fear. As I told you before, we carry the legacy of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar and Bhagat Singh. And we believe in the democracy. We believe in the rights. We believe in the constitution. And we will continue our struggle to meet our demands. And we still stand on the same demand which we put forward just after Rohitumala's murder. That is sacking and arrest of the Upper Rao. We will continue our struggle up to that limit. JBM, Lal Sram.